The first step to mastering Atticus, if you're bringing in a manuscript that you've already written, is making sure your file is ready for the most efficient importing possible. So this tutorial is going to walk you through just a very few prep steps to get your DocX file perfect for importing into Atticus so that you can format a publish-ready file in no time. Let's get started. Before we look at a document, I want to share with you a few word features that really help to prepare your document before importing into Atticus. First, I always recommend you turn on the navigation panel, especially if you're using chapter titles in your book. To turn on the navigation panel, click View from the top menu, and then make sure there's a check mark beside Navigation Pane. This allows you to navigate within your book quickly and easily, jumping to designated chapters. The second feature in Word that is extremely useful is the Show Formatting Marks feature. If you click Home from the top menu, you'll see the Show Hide Paragraph Marks button right beside the Styles panel. Having this feature turned on will show you where you have paragraph breaks, page breaks, and more formatting elements used within your manuscript. Preparing your manuscript for import. Before we get started with the few formatting recommendations, there are a couple other important things you should know about importing your book into Atticus. First, it's important to delete any table of contents you may have in your original manuscript. If it's linked within the Word document, it will create internal coding issues when the formatting is converted in Atticus. But don't worry, Atticus automatically creates a contents page for every book that is properly formatted for both EPUB and print, and automatically updates with any changes you make. Front matter. Atticus automatically creates a title page and contents page, and it's easiest to remove these pages from your Word document before importing. You'll also automatically have a copyright page template in Atticus, but if you already have one written, import it and make the few adjustments inside Atticus. If you have a dedication page, introduction, or any other front matter content, you can leave that in your Word document and simply drag and drop them into place in the front matter section after importing. Handling chapter breaks. Making sure your chapters separate properly once imported into Atticus is one of the most important steps to saving time and energy in the formatting process. There are four ways you can tell Atticus to start a new chapter. Number one, label your chapter title as Word Default Heading 1. Number two, ensure each new chapter title is 20 points or larger. Number three, insert a page break between chapters. Or number four, press Enter or Return 4 times after the last piece of body text before a new chapter begins. Setting chapter titles. If your book includes chapter titles, we highly recommend you format your chapters using one of the first two options previously mentioned. If you ensure all your chapter titles are either tagged as Heading 1 or in font that is at least 20 points in size, not only will Atticus know where to start a new chapter, but it will also import your title into the appropriate chapter title location. This will also automatically include your chapter title in the left navigation menu of Atticus, as well as the auto-generated table of contents. If you use the Heading 1 style, you'll also see them show up in the navigation pane inside Word, making it easier to navigate through your original manuscript. This is my personal preference. If you don't use chapter titles, a simple page break or four paragraph breaks between each chapters will work perfectly well for your book. This is one of the ways seeing formatting marks comes in handy. If you notice your document isn't properly adding breaks between your chapters, you may find that you've accidentally inserted a section break instead of a page break, and you'll be able to find and fix that quickly if you can see the formatting marks. On the other hand, if you notice Atticus is starting new chapters where you hadn't planned them, you may find that you've used multiple paragraph breaks in a section of your book, and Atticus understood this to mean start a new chapter. This will be obvious with formatting marks showing. Subheadings and special paragraph styles. If you have subheadings in your book, you can apply Word Default Heading 2 through Heading 6, and they will import as unique subheading formats to Atticus. Once imported, you can set the style for the subheading in your custom theme settings. You can also use subheadings to create special paragraph styles for your text. For example, if one of your characters loves to write notes, you can set their notes as Heading 3 in your Word document. Once imported into Atticus, you can set the Heading 3 style to be a script font. Don't worry what your subheadings look like in Word. You'll format them in Atticus. Always use Word default styles. If you create a custom style in Word, Atticus will not be able to interpret it. Scene breaks. Another element you may want to make sure is properly set in your Word document before importing into Atticus is your scene breaks. If you use three asterisks with no spacing or any other formatting applied to them between your scenes, Atticus will automatically convert those to placeholder scene breaks when imported. This will allow you to quickly customize the break to an ornamental design with a single click, and apply this design to all scene breaks in your entire book. Footnotes and endnotes. Finally, if you plan on having footnotes or endnotes in your final book, you'll want to set those up in Word as footnotes. Atticus will import them easily, and you can add your preferences in your theme settings. If you've already set up your notes in Word as endnotes, unfortunately, they won't transfer over to Atticus. It's super easy to convert them to footnotes, though. First, make a copy of your Word document if you don't want to alter the original. Next, open this file in Word and click the References tab. Click the Expand menu icon in the Footnote Endnote section. Click Convert and then select Convert All Endnotes to Footnotes and click OK. When you upload this version to Atticus, all notes will be recognized and added to the text, and you can select their location in the Formatting tab. Importing and customizing in Atticus. Beyond these simple formatting settings, it doesn't matter too much how your manuscript is set in Word. You'll be able to set your font styles, paragraph settings, line spacing, and much more within Atticus. If you've gone through this tutorial and are having trouble getting your manuscript to import into Atticus, here are a few extra steps to check. Number one, URLs. If you've added hyperlinks to your manuscript, they may not be formatted in a way that Atticus can import them without breaking them. We recommend clearing all hyperlinks from your docx file before you import, and set all your links directly from inside Atticus to ensure they work properly. Number two, images. If you have a lot of images, or even just a few large images, your document may be timing out before it can be imported. We recommend saving all your images into a separate folder and removing them from your docx file for most efficient importing. Once your book is in Atticus, you have the flexibility to import and format each image individually, ensuring they align perfectly with your vision. Number three, file type. Have you made sure that you're importing a docx file? The X at the end is very important. If not, try resaving as this file type and it should import more successfully. Now that your manuscript is successfully inside Atticus, it's time to start adjusting the look and feel by creating a custom theme that is unique to your book. If you'd like to see how I created the script style paragraph settings or the custom image for my scene break, check out the tutorial Create a Custom Theme next.